Okay, we're back. This is Tech Math 1. We're looking at chapter 14. So, in 14, we're going to use the graphing calculator a lot. We're going to talk about matrices. So, first, on 14.1, we'll do number 3. We're in the blue book, and we're looking at page 598. So, number 3, they want us to find the determinant of a matrix, which for a 2x2 matrix is pretty easy. And I'll show you guys how to do this, but it isn't, you guys and girls, it isn't, there's a way to solve a matrix using the determinant. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna have the calculator do all of the work. And so, so this was sort of the way that you did it kind of by hand before the calculators got so good. So when you do a determinant, you multiply down the diagonal row, and that gives you 4 times 2, which is 8. And then you subtract it from multiplying up diagonally. So 0 times -1 is 0. So the determinant of this matrix is 8. Okay, the determinant of this matrix, multiply down, that's 0, minus, multiply up, that's -2 times -3 is +6. There's a minus still in front of it, so it's 0 minus 6, which is -6. So that's it for the determinant. Those are pretty easy to find. Yeah, I guess I'll show you a Cramer's rule problem. Just one Cramer's rule problem, and it's a way that you could solve a system of linear equations, but by using determinants and matrices instead of like graphing or adding or the substitution method like we did in chapter 13. So it is a different way of solving. (4a + 3b = 1) and 3a - 2b = 22. And I'll actually show you two ways to solve this, okay? Before we get into the systems of three equations, because then we're not going to use matrices. Then we're going to use reduced row echelon form. So look, this way, Cramer's rule, this is number 8. On page 600, they want Cramer's rule, which you find the determinant, of A and the determinant of B. And so when you find these, you can solve for A and B by doing, so not even doing the, what we did with, so remember, in the last one, we could solve this. If this was X and Y, it'd be easier to look at instead of A and B. But remember, we could have multiplied this by 2 to make that 6B, and multiply this by 3 to make it -6B, and then add straight down and solve that way. That was how we solved in chapter 13. We're not going to do it that way. We're going to use determinants and Cramer's rule to solve for A and B. And so the determinant, the main determinant is you take and just get rid of the answers. So when you got linear set, this part here, the coefficients. So you dump the letters. So it is 4, 3, 3, -2. So we just pulled the coefficients out of those. We blocked that off and just looked at the ones with the variables. And A, this is the A column, this is the B column, basically. All right, that's a row and that's a row. And so we don't have the answers in there. So when you want to solve for A, what you do is you replace what you want to solve for with the answer column. So this is the answer column, 1 and 22. So if I want to solve for A, D sub A, I take that 1 and 22 and I overlay it over where the A column was. And then I leave the B column alone. If I want to solve for B, I take the answer column and I basically superimpose it over the top of the B column. So you got 4 and 3, but now I got 1 and 22 on that. All right? So now on each one of those, you find the determinant. So remember how we did that. We multiplied down and got negative 8 minus, and then you multiply up and you get 9. So that one's negative 17. You multiply down diagonally, you get negative 2 minus, and you multiply up, and what is that, 66? So that's negative 68. You multiply down, so that's 88, minus multiplying up, that's 3, so that's 85. And now, by Cramer's rule, we can figure out A. A is, it's D sub A, this thing, divided by the determinant, the main determinant. So D sub A, the determinant of D sub A, that's negative 68 over D, which is negative 17. And I think that goes evenly, like 4 times, right? 4 times. So that's positive 4. That is the answer for A. Like how we did it using the substitution or multiply and add straight down and get something to cancel or graphing. This is a different way of doing it with a matrix. So these work nicely with a little 2x2, you know, just a linear system of linear equations. It's a little bit more of a process if you do it with a 3x3, where you got X, Y, and Z, and then an answer column too. And so I'm going to show you another way to do it called using an augmented matrix and doing reduced row echelon form. And then the calculator does all the work and you just get the answers. And so here, D sub B over D. This is again called Cramer's rule. This is a way to do this. In my undergrad, I actually took a course in just matrices. 85, and we had to like prove like why all of this works. It was an okay course. It was not tons of fun. So what is that? Negative 5. Negative 5. Okay. So that is the way to do it if you're using determinants. If you were still doing pencil and paper, this would be a way to do it. Since we have technology and we all have graphing calculators, you all have that graphing calculator, I'm gonna show you another way to do it. You do reduced row echelon form. It's R ref, reduced row echelon form. And you put in what's called an augmented matrix. So 4, 3, 1, and 3, negative 2, 22. Augmented meaning that this is A, this is B, and this is your answer column. Just like, here, we won't even label it. But that's the answer column. That's why it's got an augmented there. And so what the calculator will kick out is 1, 0, and then the answer, and 0, 1, and then the answer. So just like in the movie, The Matrix, where they're all zeros and ones, that's actually the answer. The diagonal, it's called the identity matrix, is that'll give you the answer. So this is like 1A plus 0B equals what number, and 0A plus 1B equals what number. And when we do our calculator, it will come out to be 4 and negative 5. When we do the reduced row echelon form of this matrix. Okay? You also have to understand how to label matrices. They go by rows and then columns. So this is considered a 2x3 matrix. I think it goes row column. Or is it column row? I think it's row column. We'll find out right now. So we're going to put this into our calculator. I will show you the keystrokes on the calculator. Okay, so here's our handy dandy calculator. We want to type in the 4, 3, 1, 3, negative 2, 22. So we want to put that into the calculator. So what you're going to do is you're going to hit second, the second key, and then see how x to the negative 1 says matrix in yellow? And there are a matrix, okay? And so look, that's what you get for a readout. names, math, edit. So we want to edit. We're going to go to edit and see now it's highlighted on A. So I'm going to put it in matrix A. I'm going to hit enter and it says 3 by 4, but I don't want 3 by 4. I want a 2 by 2 rows, a 2 by 3. So I made it 43. Hold on, let me clear. All right, so I cleared 2 by 3. And see, now we've got the 2 rows and 3 columns. So it is rows by columns. All right, now you click down and you enter in what you want. So I want a 4. I want that to be a 3. I just hit the 3. And then you can hit, if you hit enter, it'll just click it to the right. If you hit the right arrow, it'll just click it to the right. So it doesn't matter which way you do it. So look, I'm going to hit 1. And did it put a 1 in there? It did not. Oh, so 1, and then when you hit enter, then it puts it in. All right. And then 3, and then enter. And then -2. Make sure to use the negative button in the 2. -2, and then enter. And then 22, and then enter. Okay, so now I've got it entered in. We can double check it. It's 4, 3, 1, 3, -2, 22. So we have the right matrix in there. Okay, so now we're done entering the matrix. I want you to hit second and then mode, that's quit. And we're back to the home screen. Okay, now we go second matrix again. And now this time we want to do math. And remember, I told you reduced row echelon form. So I want you to go down, 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 click the down arrow until you see reduced row echelon form, RF, not just ref, RF. All right, RF, and then hit enter. And now look, it says RF, and now hit second matrix again. And now it's on highlighting on matrix A. So if I just hit enter, it'll put the little A there. If you really, really want to, you can put the N parenthesis on it so it looks nice and neat on the readout. And then hit enter. And then it just does all the work for you. It did all of that stuff that we just put on the board, the Cramer's rule. And so we got 1, 0, 4. That means A is equal to 4. And 0, 1, -5. So that means 1B is equal to -5. So 4 and -5 are our answers. And so your calculator, all of those things that we did in chapter 13, you could do with a lot of keystrokes. That was a lot of entering on the calculator, right? To solve it. But you could check any linear equation you could do this way. So 4 and -5. So that comes in handy when you're working in the real world and you have two linear equations that don't have a nice, neat answer, like 4 and -5. Maybe it's 3.6855 and 9.3322. And so that would be a pain in the butt to put in and solve, you know, and write out, because then you're subbing in these irrational numbers where here it'll just kick it out for you. So does all the work. We like that. All right. So let's look at 14.3, a system of 3 equations. And so let's use the addition method. Yeah, we're not. I don't know if I want to do the addition method. I guess I'll demonstrate one addition method for you. But just so you can see what a pain it is to do by hand. Much time do we have here? That's 14 minutes. Okay, yeah, we'll do one addition method. But then we're going to do it this way too, with the reduced row echelon form. Okay. Because that's why we had you get these calculators, so that you could learn how to make them do all of this grunt work. So I'll demonstrate the addition method, but I don't want you to worry about this. You're not going to be tested on the addition method. 4.3. All right, so 14.3, we're going to jump to number 12. And so now look, they've got x plus y plus z equals Oh boy, I better get these right. 6 and 2x minus y plus 3z equals 9 and negative x plus 2y plus 2z equals 9. All right, and this is equation 1, this is equation 2, this is equation 3. So the reason we're labeling them 1, 2, and 3 like that is because I'm going to describe what's happening by calling these out. So look, I'm going to add 1 to 2. So I'm going to take 1 and add it to 2. And what is that going to do? That's going to get rid of the y's. All right, so x, let's make that happen. X plus y plus z equals 6, and 2x minus y plus 3z equals 9. I just add those straight down, I get 3x, the y's go away, plus 4z equals 15. So now I have another new equation. That one's gonna be, we'll call that one equation 4 or whatever. All right, so now let's go with 2 and 3. I want to get rid of y. So now this time the y's won't just disappear if I add them, because those happen to be negatives of each other, right? Positive 1y, negative 1y. So this one is going to require a little work. So I'm going to take that second equation. I'm going to multiply it by 2 to make that be negative 2y. And then I'm going to add it to the third equation that I'm not going to do anything to. So this one, everything gets multiplied by 2. We get 4x minus 2y plus 6z equals 18. I took 2 times that and that and that and that. 2 times everything, okay? This one I leave alone. Negative x plus 2y plus 2z equals 9. I add straight down, the y's die. I get 3x plus 8z equals 27, okay? Now look at what I have. I've got this equation and I've got this equation. So let's write those down. 3x plus 4z equals 15. And 3x plus 8z equals 27. And I want to get rid of the x's, right? I have a 3x and a 3x. So if I just multiply this whole thing by negative 1, I end up with negative 3x minus 4z equals negative 15. And this one, I leave 3x plus 8z equals 27. And then I add straight down and I get 4z equals, what is that? 15 and 27, is that, ooh, is that 13? No. Really? 13? No, I must have screwed something up here. Negative 4. Oh, no, 12. Oh, 12, of course. And why? Where did I get 13? 27 minus 15 is 12. Durr. Divide by 4, divide by 4. Z is equal to 3. So now we've got Z. So Z is equal to 3. I take that. I put it back into one of these two equations. We'll pop it into the top one 4 times. 3 equals 15. 3x plus 12 equals 15. Get rid of the 12. 3x equals 3. Divide by 3. X equals 1. So now we've got 3 and 1. We take those and put it into any of those. We'll put it into the first one, is the easiest. 1 plus y plus 3 equals 6. So I replace that with a 1 and that with a 3, because we just figured those out. And combine like terms, y plus 4 equals 6, and get rid of the 4, and y is equal to 2. And so that is our ordered triple, 1, 2, 3. Okay? Now, instead of doing this whole board of work and figuring out what to cancel away and then getting it down to 2 variables and then doing the problems like from chapter 13 and getting it down to 1 variable and then subbing it back in and subbing them both back in, you can do all of this in one shot with that reduced row echelon form that I showed you before. So pull away just the coefficients. 1, 1, 1, 6, 2, negative 1, 3, 9, and negative 1, 2, 2, 9. And again, we're going to do reduced row echelon form, RREF, on our calculators. And of that, and it's going to give me 1, 0, 0 answer for X, 0, 1, 0 answer for Y, and 0, 0, 1 answer for Z. It'll just read them all out, all in one shot. Let me show you the keystrokes. Okay, so here we are back on the calculator. So this time, second matrix. Go over to edit, hit enter. That's A, and it says, oh, do you want a 2x3? We don't want a 2x3 anymore. We want 1, 2, 3x4. So 3x4. That is 3 rows, 4 columns. And you'll know it's right because you have to put the numbers in from what you wrote there. So 1, enter, 1, enter, 1, enter, 6, enter. 2, enter, negative 1, enter, 3, enter, 9, enter, negative 1, enter, 2, enter, 2, enter, 9, enter. All right, so now it's all entered in there. When you got everything entered into your matrix, go second. And then mode is quit. So you want back to the home screen. And then second, matrix. And now we want to do math. And then you want to click down until you see RREF. Not just REF, RREF. So RREF, enter. And now it says reduced row echelon form of, and we want to do matrix A. So we're going to do second matrix. And it's already on A. See, we could have A, B. If you want to keep them, you could just click down and call it B or C or D or whatever. I just keep using A over and over again. And hit enter, and then hit enter. And there are answers. 1, 2, 3. So, I mean, is there some keystrokes for it on the calculator? Yes. But is it way, way, way easier than all of this? Yes, again. So 1, 2, 3. And again, that gets a lot more difficult if you end up with a real world problem and it ends up as a decimal to begin with, like a really long decimal. You got to sub that in and you got to sub in 2 really long decimals to find the third one. And so it is much, much, much easier to use the technology that we made you buy. All right.